again, everybody. TrekWorks here with you. Well, I spent a couple hours this morning working on the Defiant, working with the decals, and getting all the light leaks touched up on it, and all my paint work done, all my touch-ups. And I've also got it mounted on the Polar Light stand here. I've got a single switch which turns everything on. I'm running this with a 9-volt power adapter, and that's pretty much a nice voltage for all those LED tape strip lighting that's in there. And that seems to work out pretty good at 9 volts. It lights nice and even and not too bright and not too dark. I've also went in and put in all the micro crystal clear in all the window ports so that glare is drastically reduced from what we saw a little while ago. It takes care of that problem real quick. And then down here you can see on the bottom side we've got all our decals on the bottom as well. And those window ports are looking much, much better. And I'm really, really happy with all that. It's just a really cool looking little ship once you get it all put together. I'm really pleased with it. I wasn't too big on this model from DS9, but it's a unique design and it's definitely different than all the other ships. And it's a challenging kit to build, but it's a lot of fun. And I noticed that a couple guys over, as I mentioned yesterday, over at Sci-Fi Model Action are mentioned that they have this kit and they're going to be working on it in the near future. So I'm looking forward to checking that out. It'll be interesting to see what you guys come up with on your paint schemes and all those things. For those of you who haven't been to Sci-Fi Model Action, you might want to check it out. It's a lot of fun. We've got a great group of people over there. We've got a great forum. We've got a lot of works in progress, lots of pictures, a model gallery, and a bunch of great people over there trading information about building models, model news, all kinds of cool stuff. So if you guys get a chance, I hope you come and check that out. Again, thanks for following along on this build. It's been a lot of fun. I've still got to come back and do my weathering on this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use some modeler's chalk and basically crush that up and mix it with some water and then do a wash on that, and that's going to give me highlights on all these little individual panel lines that are on here and bring those to life, and then a little bit of airbrush work on that. So I'll come back with one final update on that once it's done. Might be a couple days before I get around to it, but that's going to help it out a lot too. But overall, I'm really, really happy with this kit. Challenging to build, but a lot of fun, and I think this kit gets a bad rap. It's not that bad of a kit at all. A little bit of sanding and a little bit of gap filling in here, like I mentioned, and the model comes up pretty nice. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this video series. I sure appreciate you guys checking out the channel, and thanks for all the nice comments, and looking forward to doing many more. So again, I'll be back in a few more days with an update on this with the weathering done on it, and that'll be it for this one, and we'll be ready to move on to our next project. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, like I said, and until we see you next time, everybody, happy modeling, you guys.